How would I describe myself? Okay. Mother, actress, director, theatre maker, and great cook. I love cooking for other people. It's sort of a big part of my personality, I reckon, is how I show my aroha for people, is to give them food, make them food. My first awareness of suffragettes was when I went to Auckland Girls Grammar School, and I was at school when it was the 100-year anniversary of the suffragette movement. And I remember at the time feeling, as a 14-year-old, feeling surrounded by women who all had a very rich story. I think going to a girls' school really influenced who I am. You know, like at a very young age, I understood the strength of women and the importance for women to stand up and be counted and have a strong voice. Essentially, being an actress, I work in an industry that is unequal. I've understood right from the start that roles for men are, there's many more of them and they're much more interesting. And right through my career, I've played the girlfriends of people rather than the character. I have noticed that when I work for women, when I work for women writers, women directors, suddenly I get to play a full character who has a story arc. I worked on a project last year with 9 wahine Māori directors. A film project called Waru, and I felt like that was really the step in the direction that we need to go. So it's giving women the opportunity to tell stories, giving them the opportunity to be behind the camera directing, and the trickle-down effect of that is that women actresses get parts to play, women crew start to come on and start working in all the roles, and that women themselves see themselves on the big screen in a way that they never have before. I'm looking at the films that used to be my favourite films when I was growing up, and I've realised that in all of them, women were treated as objects. And I can't believe that that was the only frame of reference I had for storytelling, for stories about women. I think that is the next step, that we as women must become the lead character in stories so that we start to see ourselves. I've got an 8-month-old daughter called Hero, and I find that people often sort of stop and go, oh, what, Hero, so it's a boy. And I go, no, it's a girl. Girls can be heroes too. Poor girl, she's got a lot to live up to there. I'm sort of thinking about great wahine who have inspired me as leaders in this country, and I think of women like Whina Kupa, who led the Hīkoi Land March as an old woman. I'm in my 40s, and after having 2 children, you know, my body, it's changed in it, and you know, physically the things I can do now are very different to what I could do in my 20s, and I think of how she did that walk and led so many people as an old woman in an old body. They stood up and went, right, we have to come to the front and start to lead. I find that so inspiring.